Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about how attackers perform JavaScript injections to manipulate web pages and alter resource parameters while learning measures to prevent such attacks. So let's get started. An injection vulnerability allows a malicious actor to inject harmful code into a system through another application. Hackers typically use injection attacks to access the backend server configuration, shell commands, or OS calls when the application fails to validate user input adequately. Since the web application accepts untrusted user data as part of a query or command, injection attacks allow for arbitrary dynamic code execution and user session hijacking. In a JavaScript injection attack, an attacker injects malicious code into the client-side JavaScript directly. This code launches and renders when the victim loads the website with a malicious script in their client application browser. An attacker may rely on various techniques to enter malicious code into a vulnerable site, including using the browser's developer console to insert JavaScript or change the source code, adding a script by entering JavaScript script element to the client's address bar, using cross-site scripting to add scripts into a comment or input form field. An exploit script is designed to perform several actions depending on the exact content type. Malicious exploits through JavaScript injection code include obtaining sensitive user information when they enter information submitted in an input field, forcing unwanted actions on behalf of the victim, complete user session hijacking, manipulation of website parameters. JavaScript injection exploits are known to cause severe consequences, such as loss of sensitive content. Attackers can abuse JavaScript injection vulnerabilities to steal sensitive personally identifying information, such as name, address, and credit card data. Revenue loss. Successful JavaScript injection attacks impact user experience, user traffic disruption, trust in the affected service, and financial loss. Compliance issues. Loss of sensitive data can subject organizations to penalties and lawsuits enforced by security and compliance frameworks, such as PCIDSS and GDPR. Various JavaScript injection attack types are based on the payload and exact content type. Common injection attack examples include dependency injection in JavaScript. JavaScript dependency injection is a web design pattern that enables the passing of dependencies without instantiating them within classes or functions. DI simplifies source code development and testing since dependencies are provided and loaded from external resources. A JavaScript dependency injection confusion attack targets the DI framework, where the attacker tricks the website into pulling custom scripts from their chosen repository. When installing packages for JavaScript applications, installers typically pick the latest version when faced with a choice between two versions of the same file. Suppose a malicious user can obtain the name of an internal dependency or script file. In that case, they can publish malicious application code with a higher version number in a public repository, referenced as a package engine or another source code file. When installing packages or dependencies, the malicious code gets injected into the application's source code when the installer selects the updated altered version. JavaScript hangl injection attack. Most applications rely on several methods to inject hangl markup through JavaScript. JavaScript injection through hangl involves injecting executable hangl code through a vulnerable input field. The hangl injection attack targets the browser's hangl content and interprets it on the client side. A common approach by hackers to perform this is by embedding malicious script tags into the website. Since the browser interprets scripts embedded within hangl by default, the browser plugins execute the malicious scripts. JavaScript injection HTML attacks commonly target forums, comment sections, or application interfaces that allow the insertion of user input without sanitation. Through such attacks, attackers gain access to the user's session cookies, alter the website's appearance, or add event listeners that send the user's keystrokes to a server they control. Common tags used to embed hangl code into JavaScript applications include script, object, applet, embed, fk, li, br, div, title. JavaScript code injection attacks are common on applications that accept user input and execute it on the server side. Orchestrating such attacks require attackers to use the developer tool's console or an input field to supply the malicious script, which is parsed to the server for dynamic code execution. The first code in the video shows an example of a vulnerable website. In such a code pattern, an attacker can submit malicious code to the random script, random function, to deploy an event listener. This is achieved by building a custom script in a JavaScript and jQuery compliant console to change the onclick event. The code will look similar to the second code shown in the video. Following this, all the hackers must inspect the button element after opening the web page. This grants the hacker access to an event listeners tab that displays code run by the random script function. JavaScript SQL injection attack is executed by leveraging input validation flaws to inject malicious SQL queries into the application. This modifies the original database queries, which enables the attacker to read sensitive content, modify delete database entries, or alter server behavior. Assume a noted web application uses a search term to generate a query. As shown in the video, a vulnerable application may use literal strings to include the search term directly into the code string. As per the above query construct, the SQL query string to search the term Darwin would be similar to code number 2 in the video. An attacker can supply the malicious search term Darwin, which modifies the SQL statement like code number 3 in the video. This comments out every part after the characters, effectively leaving the executed SQL command similar to code number 4. As this removes the additional clause that prevents the exposure of private repositories in the database server's response, an attacker can gain access to source code, server configuration files, and other intellectual properties of the organization. Some methods to prevent SQL injection in JavaScript applications include performing value validation and masking at the user input and data control level, using the name and query placeholders to escape user input before extrapolating it into the SQL query, query scope and type checking, preventing JavaScript code injection attacks. Preventive measures for JavaScript code injection attacks include avoiding the use of unsafe characters and functions, including the evil, setInterval, setEmeOut, and function constructor statements at the user input field. Avoiding dynamic code execution when necessary. Creating a whitelist of input values for users to choose from. Using a web application firewall to detect code strings from malicious users. Locking down the browser application interpreter and limiting its capacities to the minimum required by the web server configuration. Using a security linter to enforce a secure code style. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.